So, let's have a more detailed look on the instrument. I will switch it on again and you can see how it's booting up, showing the logo of the manufacturer and doing some basic tests. And then it's already in some basic mode where it does some measurements. There's also no preset button here because you cannot set too many strange settings on this instrument. So no need to preset, and the basic mode is to measure capacitances. And as a sample, I have this small capacitor here. So I will connect this small capacitor just to these measurement clamps. And this should be a 40 nanofarads capacitor. And as you can see, we are also measuring something like 39 point something nanofarads. And this D here is some loss factor. So that's it. This works pretty easy and pretty well. So let's take a look at another sample. I have a series connection of two of these capacitors. So they are again both 40 nanofarads, but now connected in series. And what we would expect in the series connection of capacitors is that we get half of the capacitance, so approximately 20. And that's why you can see we measure 80.8 or 80.99 something nanofarads. I have another last sample, and this one is a parallel connection of two capacitors, two 40 nanofarad capacitors in parallel. And again, we can connect them and we would expect to get now twice the capacitance. So approximately 80, and that's why we get 77.9 something nanofarads. So this is how it works for capacitors. Let's take a look at some inductor. The sample that I have here is a very simple air coil. So let's have a look at this connected to these measurement clamps. And then you can see that we are now measuring negative capacitance, which of course, yeah, does make some sense because an inductance is, and it's not really a negative capacitance, but in this sense of the measurement it is. So that's why we need to change the setup. So we go to measurement setup, and it's very small on this display here, but there's a function mode which says we measure capacitance and this loss factor. And here with this more button, we can change to a different mode where we can select inductances. And here we will select this LS and RS, inductance and resistance in series. Press escape to go back to the main menu and change back to the measurement display. And now you can see we are measuring the inductance of this coil, which is something like 0.9 microhenry. And the resistance of this wire, which is very small, just 8 milliohms. And yeah, what we can try out to increase the inductance of this air coil is we can add a core. So this is some iron screw, a magnetic screw. Insert this as a core material into this coil, and what happens is that the inductance increases, so from 0.9 to 2.8 something microhenry. Yeah, what is maybe now quite interesting, you can see that here the frequency of the measurement can also be set. In the basic setting, it's 1 kilohertz. So let's try to change this frequency, go back to the settings, select the frequency, and then there are two buttons to decrease and to increase the frequency. So we will decrease the frequency and go to the smallest frequency that is possible, 10 Hertz. Go back to the result. And now you can see it's taking much more time to measure because the periodic time at 10 Hertz is much, much, much longer. So the measurement update rate is much slower. And now again, we are measuring negative inductance, which does not make too much sense because yeah, here at this very low frequency, very small frequency, the reactance of this inductor is just very small and very difficult to measure. That's why at 10 Hertz, this measurement here does not make too much sense. So let's go back to the settings and select our basic frequency that we had before. 1 kilohertz, go back, show the result. We are back at our setting or at our result that we had before, 2.8 microhenry. Now let's see what happens if we go to an even higher frequency. Let's go to, for example, 10 kilohertz. Go back, show the result. And then you can see at 10 kilohertz, the inductance here decreases. Why? Yeah, because the permeability of this, of the core of this iron screw is not really effective anymore. If I remove it, you can see that we go back to the 0.9 microhenry. So if I increase the frequency even more, go to 100 kilohertz, the highest frequency that is possible here on this instrument in this case, then you can see we are still measuring the same, more or less same inductance of this air coil, 0.8 something microhenry. And now if I add the core again, you can see nothing happens because the permeability of this iron is just not effective anymore at this quite high frequency. So this was the inductor. And the last sample that I have prepared is a plain resistor. So very small basic resistor. You cannot see the colors here, but the colors are brown, black, and red. And you can take a look at such resistor clock, and brown for the first ring means a digit of one, a black for the second ring means a digit of zero, and this red means a multiplicator of 100. So we get 10 times 100, so 1 kilo ohm, and that's why we are measuring approximately 1,000 ohm, 980 on point something ohm. And again, we are measuring negative inductance, which means that our capacitor behaves more than a capacitor than some inductor. So we can go back to the measurement setup and change the setting once again. So here you can measure resistances and quality factors, resistance and reactance. And the last mode that is maybe useful is resistance, is impedance by magnitude and phase, phase in radians and phase in degree. So we will select this mode, go back to the main menu, change to the measurement display again, and then you can see that we are again measuring this magnitude, 981 point something ohms for the magnitude of the impedance and some very small but negative phase angle that shows a slightly capacitive behavior. And there are some more settings that you can do here on this instrument. There is a measurement or a setup for list measurements. So if you want to measure one resistor after the other, one capacitor after the other, you can do such list measurements. And there's also a setting here, open and short, where you can do an open and short calibration to get slightly more precise results, as you can do on the impedance analyzer. And again, if we go back to the main menu, there is a last setup where you can do bin measurements. So you can select a lower and an upper limit, and then again do some kind of list measurements, measure lots of components one after the other, and select them and divide them into bins so that you have selected components that you want to have for a special circuit within a very, very precise tolerance. And that's more or less all that you can set here on this instrument. There are some more settings. You can, for example, set the level of the source. You can set the source resistance. You can add some bias. You can also change the measurement speed and therefore also the measurement precision a little bit. You can add some averaging, but if you don't really know why you change this for a certain reason, I would just leave everything here within the basic settings. And that's more or less everything that you need to know to operate this instrument and do some basic measurements of resistances of resistors, capacitances of capacitors, and inductances of inductors. And now let's change back perspectives and shortly summarize what we have done.